Believe it or not, the corpse of America's greatest president was nearly stolen a few years after his death. Keep watching, and you'll really enjoy this bizarre and interesting story. On the night of the presidential election in 1876, a gang of counterfeiters out of Chicago attempted to steal the entombed, embalmed body of Abraham Lincoln and hold it for ransom. The custodian of the tomb was so shaken by the incident that he willingly dedicated the rest of his life to protecting the president's corpse. After Abraham Lincoln was assassinated in 1865, his body was taken from Washington, D.C. by train to be laid in a tomb in Springfield, Illinois. The funeral train carried the president, some 300 mourners, an honor guard, and the disinterred body of Lincoln's son, Willie, which would be laid to rest near his father. The train made 11 stops along the way, loosely retracing the route Lincoln had taken to Washington for his first inauguration, so that his body could lay in state and the public could pay their respects. The 1,654-mile journey took 13 days, during which the body was viewed by hundreds of thousands of people. In 1876, Abraham Lincoln's body lay within an above-ground white marble sarcophagus in a handsome tomb on the grounds of Springfield, Illinois' Oak Ridge Cemetery. Oak Ridge was a rural cemetery located about 2 miles outside of the town. No groundskeeper lived there. No night watchman patrolled the area around the president's tomb. And the only thing standing between Lincoln's body and any would-be grave robbers was a single padlock on the tomb's chamber door. Not even the president's sarcophagus was burglar-proof. Its lid was sealed, not with cement, but with the less permanent plaster of Paris. A little more than 10 years after Lincoln was laid in the tomb, a group of counterfeiters attempted to steal his remains and hold them for ransom, led by a small-time crime boss named Big Jim Kernelly. Big Jim was a counterfeiter, but he had fallen on hard times. His number one guy, an engraver named Ben Boyd, was stuck in prison. Without Boyd's skill, Kernelly's operation was suffering. And so, through some stroke of misguided inspiration, Kernelly decided that he would round up a gang to steal Lincoln's body and hold it for both money and Boyd's release. Kernelly recruited two members of his gang, Terence Mulan, a salon keeper, and Jack Hughes, a sometime manufacturer of counterfeit nickels, to kidnap Lincoln's body. For ransom, they would demand $200,000 in cash and a full pardon for Boyd. Before we continue, if you're enjoying this video, please take a second to subscribe to the channel. You'll be glad you did, as we have so much more dark and mysterious content coming up that you're sure to enjoy. Now, back to the story. Given the cemetery's minimalist approach to security, the gang actually had a better than even chance of pulling off the heist. But they made a significant mistake. Neither Mulan nor Hughes had any body snatching experience, so they invited a man named Louis Sweggles, who they thought was a grave robber, to help them. They couldn't have made a worse choice, because Sweggles was a paid informant, a roper of the Secret Service. Sweggles played his part as double agent well, reporting every detail of the plot to his boss, Patrick D. Tyrell, chief of the Chicago District Office of the Secret Service. On the night, Sweggles accompanied Mulan and Hughes to Oak Ridge Cemetery. Tyrell and his agents were lying in wait for them at Lincoln's tomb, witness for the comedy of errors that soon began. Although Mulan and Hughes were career criminals, they couldn't pick a lock, so they had to cut through the padlock with a file. Once inside the tomb chamber, they found that they could not lift Lincoln's 500-pound cedar and lead coffin. The inept grave robbers were considering their options when a detective's pistol accidentally went off outside. Mulan and Hughes bolted, but it wasn't much of a getaway. they headed straight back to their saloon in Chicago, where Tyrell arrested them a couple of days later. These weren't very smart bad guys, though, so they ended up back at the same bar where they had been recruited and were arrested there. They did some jail time. Kernely was never formally connected to the attempted robbery, but spent time in jail for forgery. The whole thing ended up being an embarrassment for everybody involved. But it would be a bigger embarrassment should Lincoln's body actually be stolen, and so something had to be done. The strange decision was made to recruit men who were deemed trustworthy and ask them to secretly bury Lincoln's body in an unmarked grave. These men would keep the location totally to themselves until it was time to move him somewhere more secure. They opted to bury Lincoln's body in a shallow grave in the basement of the Lincoln Tomb. His wife, Mary Todd Lincoln, joined him there several years later. Everybody visiting the tomb assumed he was still in the sarcophagus. And so, Abe Lincoln was hidden away in a forgotten grave for over a decade before he was moved to a more secure catacombs in the building. But that still wasn't the end of the jostling of Lincoln's corpse. In 1901, the tomb was refurbished, and so his body was moved one last and final time. The assembled workers opened his casket and discovered something intriguingly gruesome. The many embalming treatments Lincoln had undergone on his funeral train trip had left him very, very well preserved. He had turned copper and appeared to be made of marble now, but his mole and his beard still existed, and his features, although distorted by his wound, were intact. The American flag that rested on his chest had rotted away, and a thick yellow mold covered his clothes, but the body of Abraham Lincoln was largely uncorrupted. The last person to have laid eyes on Lincoln's face that day was a 12-year-old boy with the wonderful name of Fleetwood Lindley. When he died in 1963, out of our world went the last person to have seen Abraham Lincoln's face with their own eyes. Please click on one of the thumbnails on the screen to see more dark and mysterious content from Insanity Collection. And if you like this video, please subscribe and tap that bell icon before it taps you. Until next time, stay insane.